Be sure to check out BruceMontalvo.bandcamp.com. BruceMontalvo.bandcamp.com for my latest book, The Language of Symbols, and all sorts of merchandise from t-shirts, the Trump World Order t-shirt, the Hillary Not My President t-shirt, or the Jail Soros t-shirt, all available at the Bruce Montalvo store, the official Bruce Montalvo store at BruceMontalvo.bandcamp.com.
TalkStream Live introduces our first ever iPhone application, Mobile Talk Radio. Imagine having the freedom to take live talk radio with you anywhere you go. You'll be surprised how easy it is to use.
So I think what's going on here is that Obama is banking on unemployment falling.
Listen to live talk shows 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. TalkStream Live. Now available in the iTunes App Store.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. North Korea state media is reiterating the country's goal of developing a nuclear missile capable of reaching the continental United States. The statement comes after the U.S. and South Korea reported a failed missile launch from an area near Pyongyang. We get the latest from correspondent Ben Thomas.
A U.S. official says North Korea tested what was likely a medium-range ballistic missile, but it broke up minutes after launch and fell into the Sea of Japan. The White House says President Trump was briefed on the matter last night. In a tweet, he accused North Korea of showing disrespect to China, and specifically President Xi Jinping.
Also at SRNnews.com, the president at the NRA convention in Atlanta Friday, he reaffirmed his support for gun rights.
The 8-year assault on your Second Amendment freedoms has come to a crashing end.
Mr. Trump became the first sitting president to address the group's annual convention in more than 30 years, assuring the audience he would defend their right to bear arms. Today marks 100 days in office for the president, but as correspondent Rita Foley reports, it's not quite the job Mr. Trump expected.
President Trump says he loved his old life. "I had so many things going," he tells the Reuters news agency. The presidency, he says, is more work than his old job. "I thought it would be easier," he says. Mr. Trump describes a loss of privacy and says life in the White House is like being in your own little cocoon. Rita Foley, Washington.
Meanwhile, the president marks his 100th day in office with a trip to Pennsylvania, where he's expected to sign an executive order directing his administration to conduct a study of U.S. trade agreements. Later, there's a rally planned in the state capital of Harrisburg. It was on this day in 1945, during World War II, that American soldiers liberated the Dachau concentration camp in Germany. This is SRN News. A new map of global persecution. SRN's Michael Harrington has details.
Researchers at Notre Dame have released a wide-ranging study of religious intolerance toward Christians around the world, and it reveals the usual suspects are mostly to blame. The study, entitled Under Caesar's Sword, Christian Response to Persecution, finds the worst abuses of believers are to be found in the predominantly Muslim nations of the Middle East and Africa. Russia is also singled out for its repression of all but the Orthodox faith. Michael Harrington, SRN News.
The U.S. Holocaust Memorial Museum's opened a new conservation and research center in Bowie, Maryland, just outside Washington, D.C. The David and Fella Chappelle Family Collections Conservation and Research Center is a state-of-the-art facility with 103,000 square feet for documents and artifacts, with room for expansion. The center will house thousands of items too numerous to be displayed at the museum. This is SRN News. In his weekly address, President Trump says the first 100 days of administration has been, quote, just about the most successful in our country's history.
"Most importantly, we're bringing back jobs. You ask the people of Michigan, you ask the people of Ohio, you can ask the people of Pennsylvania, see what's happening, see the car companies come roaring back in. They don't want to leave. They want to stay here. They want a piece of the action."
But Hawaii Senator, Democratic Senator Ben Brian Schatz says the first 100 days have been unlike any other.
"From the nominations of unqualified cabinet secretaries like Betsy DeVos and Scott Pruitt to the failed attempt at banning Muslim refugees from our country, this administration and this Congress have governed with cruelty and have broken every promise they made to the American people."
You can check out more details. Log on to srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Video of the week.
Oh yeah, if you want to support Bruce Montalvo and all the Montalvo maniacs, yeah, be sure to go to paypal.com, yeah, and type in the Bruce Montalvo Show at gmail.com, yeah. And you can give Montalvo a $5 donation, $25 donation, even 25 cents, yeah, helps in the fight against the New World Order. Support the Bruce Montalvo Show. Go to paypal.com, the Bruce Montalvo Show at gmail.com, and help out the Montalvo Maniacs, yeah.
Go to Antique Obsessions for the hottest in jewelry, antiques, repurposed, solid sterling silver, one-of-a-kind, handmade by Bruce and Jaja. Go to our Facebook, which is Antique Obsessions, or you can go to Etsy.com and go to Antique Obsessions, one word, or type it into your Google and find us there. Thanks.
Tribal, primitive, rustic, Burning Man, punk rock.
Conceptual subculture for the edgiest, most cutting-edge designs of jewelry today. Go to Etsy.com/shop/conceptual subculture. Or one word, either by going to Google or search Etsy, ETSY.com, and type in one word, conceptual subculture. You will find the hottest designs using natural stones with wire wrap rings, rough, raw, genuine, semi-precious gemstone jewelry, solid sterling silver, copper, leather, organite, bracelets, pendants, chokers, men's copper cups with sterling accents, eco-friendly, repurposed, original, one-of-a-kind design earrings. Support MBN by going to Conceptual Subculture on Etsy. Be sure to use our 40% off coupon, Bruce40, at checkout to receive this fabulous offer.
Warning, warning, everything I say is fucking crazy and should not be reinterpreted or reenacted because you will be either shot or NDAA'd. Warning.
That tubby fuck in North Korea just doesn't get it. And he went ahead and fired another one of his toy missiles.
So depressed. I don't know what to do.
Hey, go for it, man.
It's easy for you to say you got the promotion.
Look, it'll come, all right? Just don't worry about it.
The feeling is definitely there. It's a new morning in America. Fresh, vital. The old cynicism is gone. We have faith in our leaders.
About to incite a riot. Make some noise, break up the silence. Scream and shout, no being quiet. Spread the facts until you buy it. Come to my den, I got toys for torture. We drink the blood fresh just to stay immortal. We bring a thug fest, calling all New Yorkers. And keep a bayonet for the future slaughters. Kind of, sort of.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to a man that can sing Filipino in the shower. You're listening to the Bruce Montalvo Show.
That's why, guys, I heard him. It was incredible. He redid Manny Pacquiao, didn't you?
What are you talking about? I am Manny Pacquiao.
Yeah, you're going to be the next president of the Philippines and take out...
No, I am not lying. I can sing in Filipino. You want to hear?
It was amazing.
Here we go. Gagawan ko ang lahat ulo para sa'yo. Kung ainta day halahang kung pag magkasuno. Para sa'yo ang laban na to. Para sa'yo ang laban na to. Okay, that's enough of that.
Hey, now you're going to start imagining him butt naked.
Oh, puto! I'm going to run the Philippines soon para sa'yo. Duarte, I'm coming for you. That's his next fight.
That guy's a piece of shit, Duarte.
That's his next fight. He's going in for the knockout punch.
He's killing drug dealers. He's like... taking him off the street.
Well, as long as he's killing, like, meth dealers, that's fine. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the one and only, the Bruce Montalvo Show. I'm joined by Jaja on the right here.
Yes, that's right.
That's right. And it is April 28, 2017, in case you didn't know what day you were living in and what show you're listening to. This is the Bruce Montalvo Show.
That's right, Bruce.
That's right. And, how about that Kim Jong-un? You know, we told him, hey, stop firing your little toy freaking rockets or we're going to shove them up your bungholio.
Yeah.
And he just won't listen.
No, I think we should make him into Kim Jong Chalfun.
Kim Jong Chalfun. You know, I think he's been diagnosed with a disease. I think he has a disease. I think he's Kim Jong Unhappy, okay, because... he's got projectile dysfunction. He just keeps firing things. What's his problem? We told him, don't fucking do it. Don't do it. We're going to blow you away. And he just won't listen. Is it because he speaks another language? Is there like a language barrier here?
No. There's nothing to do with linguas. It has to do with... I think it has to do with the show. I think it's really Dr. Strangelove and how I need to stop worrying and just love the bomb because it's bullshit.
The bomb or La Bamba? Which one?
Yeah.
Because I like La Bamba.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not going to sing that one.
No.
Because I'll be like that cat from the video of the week. That's right. You know, this cat right here. Look at my screen, Jaja. You see him? He's jumping... he's like, it's like someone gave him some like Filipino crack or something. You see that?
Oh my God.
Yeah. You could see that if you subscribe. You can see what we're seeing if you subscribe to the Bruce Montalvo Show on YouTube and you'll see the video of the week. But let's get serious here. I mean, Kim Jong-un, he wants us to feel like this pussy here. You know what I'm saying? Scared, right? But we're not scared. Trump's not scared. I mean, do you remember what Trump said to ISIS? He told ISIS that he would bomb the shit out of him. But don't take my word for it. How about you listen to this clip of the presidente saying it himself?
ISIS is making a tremendous amount of money because they have certain oil caps, right? They have certain areas of oil that they took away. They have some in Syria, some in Iraq. I would bomb the shit out of them. I would just bomb those suckers. And that's right. I'd blow up the pipes. I'd blow up the refinery. I'd blow up every single inch. There would be nothing left. And you know what? You'll get Exxon to come in there in 2 months. You ever see these guys, how good they are, the great oil companies? They'll rebuild that sucker brand new. It'll be beautiful. And I'd ring it, and I'd take the oil.
You hear that? It would be fantastic. He said 2 months. Sound like a Brooklynite. 2 months, I go in there, I bomb the shit out of him. So, didn't you get the memo, Kim Jong-dong? Huh? Kim Jong-dongless? Okay? He's just mad because his balls never dropped. Is that it? Or he's got those little, like, Asian man balls? You know what I'm saying? You gotta, you know, like, use a fucking microscope or a stethoscope to see it. He's boneless.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they have those parades, because really he's just, he's compensating for something else, right?
Probably. It sounds about right. You know, no dick. Small dick. You know, he's China's little...
bitch.
Boogeyman, yeah.
He's China's little bitch. That's what he is.
Yeah, he doesn't do anything without China's help.
Oh, but remember, hey, let's thank the Clintons for making North Korea nuclear. Because if it wouldn't have been for them, they wouldn't have any fucking nukes. Right?
Yeah.
But regardless of all that, Russia is saying that it's a distraction. Like you said earlier, Dr. Strangelove, how I learned to love the freaking bomb. Mm. And Russia's saying right here, Russia claiming North Korea is a distraction. That's huge.
Mm-hmm.
That's huge, okay? With a Y. And a bunch of G's. Says here, the Russians are claiming it's a distraction. Russian media is beginning to make a lot of noise, saying North Korea is nothing but a distraction. But on the other hand, I'm hearing reports that the UN is preparing for a mass casualty event on U.S. soil. Or is that just fear-mongering by the fear-mongers? I mean, they have been preparing since August of last year.
You mean Operation Gotham?
Gotham Shield, that already went down. When we were on the air last week, remember, it was New York City, San Francisco, and Los Angeles that all lost power. And that's what they were drilling for. It was a EMP drill. I mean, this goes back all the way to the 60s when they had Operation Dominic, and they were testing to see how EMP-proof the U.S. would be. And that's what I think is the scariest thing, because remember, folks, North Korea has a satellite circling the United States as we speak called the Kwangmyongsong-4. I know you guys love how I say it, right? The Kwangmyongsong-4, okay, with a side of fried rice. It's flying above us right now. Hell, it was flying over our fucking state the other day. I couldn't believe it. I mean, yo, if I was Trump, I would have bombed the shit out of him the second day I was in office.
I don't think it's above us. I think it's as real as Google Santa.
Google Santa, huh?
Yeah, I think it's a boogeyman, Bruce.
They always use the boogeyman. You know, it's like, oh, you got to fear the big communist boogeyman. Meanwhile, they got a fucking space station, and we're working with them, and now the Russians are in the Arctic. And I was looking at that combat base the Russians have in the Arctic. It was very snazzy. But it looks like something out of Star Wars, like the fucking planet Hoth or something.
Hmm.
I mean, it's crazy. But, I mean, what are they preparing to do? I mean, it seems that nobody cared. You know, we keep telling the people, hey, you know, they're doing this, they're doing that. And they do it right under our noses, and nobody gives a shit.
But China is the one that also has, like, a NASA, not NASA, but something like NASA. Their space station's huge, you know, and it's all Chinese, and they're fucking smart. So, but I think we're all working together. I don't think that Kim Jong-un is a real threat, and I do believe he's a boogeyman, because if he was a real threat, we would have been there already. And I think we were there already.
And remember the predictive programming that Hollywood has always instituted and used. I mean, remember The Interview? They said they killed him in that interview. And, you know, that's what I hope happens in the end, or if it didn't happen already and this is all just Dr. Strangelove, I really hope that Kim Jong-un ends up like in the finale in The Interview where they just fucking blow him away.
Well, you know, Bruce, there's a show that's coming out called Wag the Dog, just like the movie. And the fact is Wag the Dog is basically a film about a guy who's a filmmaker, and the government comes to him and says, we want to co-opt you, and he rejected. It was like Dustin Hoffman. So they want to make a whole, that was years ago, but they want to make a whole series about it, a TV show, which is indicative of what's going on today, because it's just so blatant, you know?
Because remember, we covered it like 2 years ago, and they even demonetized our video where we talk about it, that and their whole fake Ebola thing. We talked about it. It was in the news. It was on the very fake news, CNN. They said, Kim Jong-un's sister's running the show. He's been missing. Oh, he had a cheese-eating problem.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we didn't forget. Look. He could be up there, be a clone, be some reptilian with like a freaking mask. We don't know. A hologram.
He was killing his cousins and uncles and.
Oh, he's machine gunning them.
Yeah. Yeah, I think he was taken
out. What, he poisoned that other one recently? He killed him? He sent like some freaking North Korean killer babe to kill him right in the airport?
Yeah, I mean, who knows how many clones or how many sons and daughters Kim Jong-il had. You don't know.
And they want to have their day in the sun, right? They want to blow us away. No, but, you know, whether their missiles really do have the capability to kick our asses or not, I mean, their rhetoric is out of control. You should see this. Look, North Korea's new propaganda video puts White House in crosshairs. That's from the Daily Shit News. But regardless, it's a propaganda video where North Korea literally blows up the White House.
Yeah,
they blow up the fucking White House. I couldn't believe it. I mean, the balls on this Kim Jong-un. I just said he didn't have any, but whoa. Look, Trump just said, hey, you want me to fucking blow you away? I'm going to fucking blow you away if you test another missile. And the stupid son of a bitch just tested another missile today.
So they say it could be America over there. And
you see here, Putin warns North Korea situation has seriously deteriorated. North Korea crisis, worst I've ever seen, top Navy officer. So, I mean, this is escalating and escalating beyond belief.
You know, they're looking for a reason to go in there, but...
That's true, because you got to remember, North Korea, Russia, what do they have in common? The Rothschilds don't have a centralized banking system in both of those countries. So it's very prominent that Mr. Burns, a.k.a. Rothschild, release the hounds. Called Donald Trump, you know what I'm saying? Because Donald Trump is at least knee deep into the swamp, right? So he's got Rothschild's number, and Rothschild's like, release the hounds. I mean, release the mother of all bombs. No, wait. He told him, hey, go after freaking North Korea and start some shit with Russia because I need to put a bank in there. I mean, could he have done that?
No.
No. And why is that, Jaja?
Well, I mean, their people are enslaved.
Right.
As far as we know, I saw a show about prisons all over the world years ago, and they got into North Korea, and it was just the worst place in the world.
Yeah, it's like a freaking concentration camp. The whole country is a goddamn FEMA camp.
They showed the people. It wasn't like, you know...
Was it worse than the Jews and the Holocaust?
It was very... They were like emulating it, and it was disgusting.
Wow. But riddle me this. Could this be just some big conspiracy to cover up a potential disclosure of otherworldly life in 2017? I mean, are they trying to just dangle the little puppets, you know, the Kim Jong-uns in our face? Because in reality, we're getting close to discovering something that's bigger than ourselves. I mean, if we go back to the 1960s report, the Brookings Institute, the Brookings Report, I mean, they knew that people would go batshit crazy if we figured out that there was other entities or other sentient beings besides ourselves. Mm. So, I mean, what is it, a big dog and pony show to cover up the fact that there really are other entities, that we're not alone? Or am I just being like Mulder from the X-Files?
Well,
go ahead, Scully.
I haven't seen an otherworld entity, and I'm not saying that they don't exist, but...
Look at my eye. Look. I'm doing the reptilian thing right now. You're looking at one right now.
Why should somebody, you know, like a high-level intel person get to see one and not me? Why didn't they visit me?
Jackie Gleason got to saw one, according to one of his stories, Richard Nixon. You know, the guy that says, pow, right in the kisser?
Yeah. And you know, Russia has many, many videos of fake aliens.
Oh, forget about it. Look, if you go back, look, the Russians... would actually, I mean, they have a lot of reverse engineered technology, but the Russians would actually have a mandate, the Russian government, to shoot down any UFO and reverse engineer it, but they would make their bases from an aerial view look like crop circles or, you know, hieroglyphics to possibly attract something to show up.
They control the man. Insane. Listen, they can control...
Was it the Kapustin Yar?
I don't think it's about a boogeyman. I don't think it's about an alien. I think it's about creating a boogeyman to create fear with the population. They want to control the masses. They want, you know, for people to be biting at the nails.
What if at the very top of the freaking pyramid, okay, aliens run the whole fucking show. Because look at this report right here. NASA is about to make big announcement about Saturn and extraterrestrial life. You know, they sent out that Cassini or whatever, that little satellite on the rings of Saturn, was taking pictures and all this stuff. I mean, I haven't heard NASA, what I like to call Nazi, I haven't heard them say anything. I don't think they're ever going to disclose that we're not alone.
No, I don't think they'll ever disclose that there's a flat Earth, so.
Oh, that too. Oh, well, everything is globe, right? You hear it on the news. The news around the globe, the fucking Harlem Globetrotters, right?
But speaking of NASA, did you know that, like, 8 hours ago, they actually said it's official, humans are going to Mars. NASA has unveiled their mission.
You know what? We haven't even been able to go back to the moon, supposedly. I mean, did we ever go? But, I mean, now we're going to fucking Mars? Really? Really? Really, bro?
Okay, do you know, Bruce, that, I know that you know this, that those photographs that they show with the red sky are filters. There are videos, and even NASA revealed it, that they put a red filter there because they wanted, and they just take away the red filter and it adjusts quickly to our blue skies and sand dunes. Now, yeah.
Right, and look at Phoenix, Arizona. I mean, just right up the street. I mean, they could simulate, you know, just like they simulated the whole moon landing thing. What was it, at MGM Studios? What they have, the guy?
Kubrick
filmed the fucking thing, and then they whacked him after it?
Look at New Mexico. We drove through New Mexico. That place is, you can go 50 fucking miles and not see a house, okay? It's all like desert, dunes.
I thought we were going to get abducted by aliens and anal probed.
Yeah.
I mean, we were scared, remember? We were like, drive was getting dark. I was like, Jaja, what if there are aliens out here?
No, you know what it is?
What if aliens exist?
There's NASA's, you know, the Roswell's over there.
That's right.
Yeah. So I think that they probably use, NASA works with Roswell, and they probably do film.
Let me tell you what they did, and I heard this from a reliable source. I heard it was Chinamen that they were experimenting on, and those were the aliens of Roswell, and they were like getting radiated or whatever. So people thought that the Chinamen that had been mutated were aliens, but it was really just
China.
I was getting that Chinamen. Yeah,
no, they look like Cambodians actually. To me.
So you hear that, folks? If you think we're gonna go to Mars, I got one little sound effect for you. That's right. I don't see us going to fucking Mars anytime soon. But that being said, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Bruce Montalvo Show. We are on TalkStream Live, 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Mountain Time. TalkStream Live. You can listen to the show on Spreaker.com/the Bruce Montalvo Show. Be sure to go to Stitcher.com. Check out the archives there on Stitcher.com/the Bruce Montalvo Show. Listen to us on iTunes, iTunes.com/the Bruce Montalvo Show, and follow us on Twitter @Bruce Montalvo, @Jaja. If you have any suggestions, if you think Jaja should wear a shirt that shows off her jugs more, I mean, you're not going to see it. I am, but I would appreciate
that.
Or just be topless. Hell, I could be topless right now, just like Alex Jones. I'll rip my shirt off right on air right now, right?
Oh, my God. Could you believe what's happening to boy Alex Jones?
Well, I can't believe my boy Alex Jones actually slept with over 160 chicks. Whoa. That's the tweet of the week, actually. I tweeted to him that he was a mega pimp, and then I put #megapimp/Bill Hicks. Because, you know, that's that thing we got going on, where I call him Bill.
It's pretty fucked up that Chobani's even suing him. I mean, he's allowed to...
I mean, what did he say about Chobani? What did he say? That the people at the Chobani yogurt factory are, like, nutting in the yogurt? I mean, what did he say that was so bad? If anything, look, don't eat that shit because, you know, it's owned by Danone or I don't know. Don't quote me. But all those big fucking yogurt companies, I mean, all their cows are eating that Fukushima grass. Right? Well, and that's radiated. I mean, it's gone around the world, the flat plane. How many times now since Fukushima happened? I mean, the cows are eating that freaking radiated grass, all thanks to Fukushima.
They're two separate companies, because I just looked it up, and it says here from the New York Post of 2016, Chobani must stop ads claiming that Dannon contains chlorine. So what's fucked up is that they're going ahead and suing little Alex Jones over there for expressing his fucking opinion, which he's allowed to. He didn't purposefully misrepresent.
Let me tell you something, Jaja. This is Mike Tyson here. You know, it just makes me so mad what they're doing to Alex Jones. I want to take them. And whoever's talking bad about Mr. Jones, I want to take them. I want to stomp their testicles and their children's testicles so they can feel my pain, because that's the pain I feel every day.
And what about his rude-ass ex-wife? Oh, my God.
What a bitch. Oh.
That is just atrocious. You don't air out your ex-husband or husband in public. It's just vile. And you know what? I never really liked her because, you know, Bruce and I work together and we have a very tight communication. And I really never understood why Violet or Kelly, whatever the fuck her name is, she never showed her face.
Right.
She never had an opinion. She never made a little 15-minute segment once a week. It just didn't seem like she was connected to him. And I figured she probably was smart enough to be with him, so she had something intelligent to say. And she was just like,
she was just bitching about chihuahuas. Look, I see a chihuahua every day, okay? It's on Fox News. I think it's called Geraldo, right? Yeah. Okay, so, I mean, there's chihuahuas, freaking, you know, that should be actually put down, like that one.
So why do Mexicans tend to have chihuahuas as their pet dog?
I don't have a fucking chihuahua. Oh, wait, that's because I wasn't born in Mexico. That's right, but go ahead.
But you grew up with one.
You bastard.
Because they think that the state of Chihuahua is... it makes them the national dog.
So is that your corny joke of the day?
Yeah, and I made it up.
She made it up. That's right. You see, they identify with Chihuahua so much because they have a fucking state called Chihuahua. What a bunch of dumbasses.
Yeah, really. They probably would too.
Anyway, let's get into the pros and cons of Trump, because that's what we always do. I got some pros. And all you Palestinian or Palace-idiot, pubic-hair-bearded fucking Jew haters, I bet you're really hating that Trump just passed or is looking to pass the Taylor Force Act. That's right, the Taylor Force Act, introduced by Lindsey Graham. It's going to cut off all funding to the Palestinian terrorists, which is what they are. They're fucking terrorists.
Yay!
And you know what? I'm going to play some clips here in case you don't believe us. I mean, listen to their so-called president, the defanged fuck Abbas. You're not gonna understand right away because we don't have anybody translating or nothing. But trust me when he says that there's no drop of blood in Jerusalem that is not a good drop of blood. If they spilling the blood of the Jews and it's good.
Yes,
so that's what he says. I'm going to play the clip.
إلى الأمام إن شاء الله نحييكم نحيي المرابطات والمرابطين نحيي كل ذرة دم أريقت في سبيل القدس فهي دماء نظيفة دماء نقية دماء في سبيل الله إن شاء الله وكل شهيد سيكون في الجنة وكل جريح سيكتب له الله الثواب كل إجراءاتهم لن نسمح بها هذه التقسيمات هذا الأقصى لنا والقيامة لنا كلها لنا لا يعني حق لهم أن يدنسوها بأقدامهم القذرة.
Could you imagine having to hear that bastard talk, that having that guy be your big brother every day? I mean, no wonder the Palestinians are so stupid. Their language sounds fucking retarded. That's their war cry. No, but really, listen to this little girl's war cry in preschool, talking about disgusting, folks. Okay, they want to talk about being oppressed. Okay, these fucking Arab camel jockeys have been oppressing Jews for centuries now, okay? They make roads out of Jewish cemeteries to step over Jewish graves, okay? They don't give a fuck, all right? They tell their kids to stab Jews.
How do little kids think like that? That's what shows you It's disgusting. Let me tell you something, all you fucking Palestinian
lovers. All you Palestinians out there.
Those people are uncivilized barbarians, and you're pigs for thinking that they are more human than a Jew, than an Israeli. Because if you talk to an Israeli, they feel bad about the whole situation. The average Israeli does not want to see a Palestinian hurt. Okay? They really don't want to.
But let me play this clip. Look, it is just indicative of what these evil palace idiots are inculcating their children to stab Jews. I'm going to play the clip right here. Oh, there you hear it. There you hear it. A parent saying, oh, what do you do to Jews? And she says, stab them. Unfucking believable. Unbelievable. And then I saw a recent video that Bibi put out. And you saw it. It was like, they're fucking cowards. They're like hiding. And, you know, they got their faces covered. Just like the pussies over here in Berkeley. The little Antifas. I'd like to see them go toe-to-toe with me. I'll fucking crack their fucking skull with a DDT on the side of the fucking street. How about that? Huh? I'd like to see them try to step to me. Okay? You know what it would be like for them? I'd make them put their fucking teeth on the curb. That's right, like that movie. Face the curb, you bastards! That's right. No, but it's bad. It's bad when you have a boss saying that he welcomes every drop of blood spilled in Jerusalem, every Jewish drop of blood. I mean, that literally, I mean, I want to freaking enroll in the IDF just hearing that.
I know.
Kick some fucking palace idiot ass.
Well, we used to know Palestinians in Brooklyn, and, like, they were all right, whatever. They were.
Oh, they're just smart enough. They're just smart enough to run the freaking washing machines, that's all.
Yeah, but they ran the fuck out of there. You know what I'm saying? They didn't really want part of that idiocracy. They wanted to have a nice life. And, you know, those who really want to leave the terrorist state, they wouldn't even be in Palestine. They would be in Israel with the rest of the people. There's a lot of Arabs, and I don't want to call them Palestinians, because once you declare yourself a Palestinian, then you're not Israeli, you know. So there's a lot of Arabs and Muslim people that live in Israel, and they live in peace. But, you know, the hatred is just vile, and it's about time that people stop hating Jews.
You see, Baer and Congress would pressure Palestinian government to cut off terror ties. Trump will raise the issue of payments during the visit. So this was this was back when Abbas was coming over to meet with Trump. And it's not looking good for the Palestinians. I mean, this isn't Obama here who gave a final fuck you round to the United States and Israel as he gave them. How much money did he give them?
Well, in 2015, he gave them $350 million.
Unfucking believable.
And Trump blocked the $259 million that were in December, that it was scheduled in December to hit their pockets. But, you know, they say, like, this quote here is that if you die as a terrorist, as a martyr, your family will get an annual stipend greater than the average Palestinian earns. In this case, a terrorist who killed Taylor Force was hailed as a hero, was basically given a state funeral.
I mean, what do? I mean, if
they're using our money
to name soccer fields or statues, you know, or, you know, coliseums or what, I mean, whatever, out of freaking mud hut, whatever they build for whatever they have to build, they name it after terrorists.
Yeah, it's part of the American budget. Part of the American fucking budget was to praise their killers. Do you understand that? Do you know how fucking horrible that is? Israel would never do that. They would never praise a killer, okay?
No, and what really grinds my gears is that they come over here and they put on their stupid fucking burqa and they say, oh, it is a sign of freedom. And then I hear that the UN appointed Saudi Arabia, I think this is like a joke or fake news, I don't know what, but I saw it on the internet, that Saudi Arabia was appointed to watch over women's rights. Are you fucking kidding me? Women can't even drive a car in Saudi Arabia. They can't go outside without their husband, or they can't, you know, play sports or do anything.
They can't go out uncovered. They can't, I think, I'm not sure if they can hold jobs or anything even, you know. I think, I don't know, it's really fucked up. It's, I think it's a joke.
Yeah, it's a joke, almost as much of a joke as North Korea being a real threat.
What are they gonna?
Because we're starting to figure it's all phony baloney, fucking Dr. Strangelove wanting us to learn to love the bomb or forget about it.
Yeah.
Just fucking forget about it.
I mean, a Saudi man is going to be in charge of my fucking rights? Yeah, I don't think so. What are you going to have me give me a clit operation?
Oh my God. That'll be the last thing they do. They got to, you got to go through me. Listen to me. I will fucking kill you now.
Yeah. You cover up those ankles. Okay.
Disgusting. No, I remember walking in Brooklyn. They look like the fucking Cobra Commander walking past you and shit with like the evilest fucking eyes you could imagine.
Oh, Germany. They put a ban actually today on the full burqa. When you're employed. You cannot hold a job, or maybe it's a government job, but you can't hold a position and have a full fucking burqa. Yay, Germany!
Yay, Germany. Now, moving on here, it seems that El Presidente, El Gran Trump, he's turning into emo Trump. Yeah, today he was like listening to emo or something. I don't know, he was like, you know, going through his old records and he put on Sunny Day Real Estate or something. No, he's just, he misses his old life, okay? He misses his old life. He said, you know, he didn't think it'd be that hard, you know? But to tell you the truth, folks, I know that he didn't want to be president. I mean, you go back to those interviews he did with Oprah, remember? Okay, he said, you know, or with Larry King, he said, I don't think I want to be president. And I don't think I want Donald Trump to be that president. But you know what? He needed to be the president. He realized it because he had to save America from Hillary Clinton. I mean, could you imagine if Hillary Clinton be in right now, we would have no gun rights. That's why he was meeting with the NRA today. I mean, she would be working diligently to take away our guns.
Even my postman said something about the last guy who let in all the freaking immigrants.
Yeah, the stinky Somalians.
Taking over
right.
our neighborhoods with, you know, pissing in pools and bringing their diseases.
Not just pissing in pools, but remember, in Austria, these so-called refugees should be called rape-ugees because they actually butt-raped a 10-year-old boy at a swimming pool. You know, what was it? The CDC said that, what, leishmaniasis is a flesh-eating bacteria that these fucks are carrying. He's over there dipping his leishmaniasis into the pool. Then he gets horny and decides to fuck a 10-year-old boy. Unbelievable.
Yeah. No, these people, you know what? I don't mind immigrants. I have no problem. This whole country was founded on immigrants. But, you know, they used to go to Ellis
Island. Oh, that's what the Industrial Revolution. Right, they used to have to go to Ellis Island, and they would check them for diseases there.
Yeah, they do not. During Obama's fucking presidency, there was nobody checked, okay? And people, you left fucking people keep saying, oh, yes, they got checked.
All these left-wing fascists, really, they have their head up there.
You don't even know, okay? Why have the reports? You go check them, okay? These people were not checked.
You know what they are? I'll tell you what they are. They're high-functioning retards. That's what these fucking Democrats are, okay? High-functioning retards. Just a bunch of fucks, okay? All of them. The Schumers, the Pelosi's, the Pocahontas, okay? You can all eat a dick. You hear me? Eat a big fat dick, you stupid fucking communists. You make me sick!
Yeah, I can't stand that Schumer. I mean,
hey, you know, that's what I want to do. You know, I want to take the children and I want to stomp on the children's testicles so they can feel my pain. Because that's the pain I always feel when I see Democrats on CNN.
Oh my God.
You know, the Marxist-Leninist media. You hear me? I want Mike Tyson to stomp on your children's testicles so you can feel our pain. Because that's the pain we feel every day.
Yeah, and speaking of Schumer, you know, Indian Point, you know, they're trying to say Entergy is Indian Point closure is not good for the environment. You know, what's his name? Cuomo I think he's actually a pretty good guy. He was really going, shut that fucking shit down. It's killing New Yorkers. I have a friend that died with prostate cancer that was 18 miles from the plant.
Yeah, we're going to end up like in The Simpsons, you know? They're like eating radioactive pizza and they're drinking like radioactive and like, you know, they're popping popcorn in the nuclear reactor core. I mean, that's what we're heading
like
toward.
Like the Ninja Turtles, you know, where there's just... But yeah, they're completely... It's a slow kill, okay? The water's toxic over in New York. The groundwater got leaked in.
Well, that's the main reason why we left, because we got totally freaked out about the Indian Point power plant spill.
Yeah, friends were catching
thousands of nuclear waste were pumped into the groundwater.
Well, the groundwater was supposedly, what is it, like 100,000 times worse than the allotted, you know, than would be safe. So it was 100,000 times
unbelievable.
Not safe. It doesn't go anywhere. Where's it going? It disperses and it trickles into your bloodstream little by little by little.
Yeah, talk about soft kill.
Yeah, it's tritium. It's just...
But you know what? That power plant has been the target of, like, terrorist attacks. So could you imagine if, like, Kim Jong-un targets Indian Point? I mean, that's mega death right there. And I'm not talking about Dave Mustaine, folks.
Right, right. And you know what? It's a slow death just being, you know, being there. People are getting sick and they don't even know it.
And Hillary wouldn't have done a damn thing, even despite the fact that the bitch lives not so far from it. Okay, Trump said it today, okay? Moving on. He said, you know, that he was like feeling like Charlton Heston from like fucking Planet of the Apes. He's like telling Obama, get your damn dirty hands off me, you bastard. That's not how the line went. And then you call me racist, right? Oh, he was racist. Yeah, he was praising tough guys like Charlton Heston. I mean, could you imagine? I mean, I'll tell Obama, get your damn dirty ape hands off my fucking guns, you stinking bastards. Because that's what they wanted to do. So if Hillary Clinton would have been in today, could you imagine? We'd have no shotguns. We'd have no rifles. No handguns. Nothing. Okay, and Trump said it. He said, the assault on gun rights is over, okay? And we still have our guns, thanks to Trump. So, yeah, I'm pro-Trump again. I flip-flop. I'm kind of like Trump myself. Like last week I said, I'm not pro-Trump.
Oh,
and then this week I am pro-Trump.
I fucking love that guy.
Well, I love the guy, but I don't love his administration. I mean, it's filled with fucking Swamp Thing's friends, okay?
Yeah, but that's to be expected. At least, you know, you listen to him. He sounds great.
Yeah, he sounds great. I mean, the Democrats, they don't even matter anymore. I saw that on the cover of Time magazine when I was wiping my ass because we ran out of toilet paper. So I just grabbed the Time magazine. I said, fuck it. And I had Charles Schumer's face. I said, even better. Okay? So, you know, I wiped my ass with Charles Schumer's face. And on the cover it said, do the Democrats even matter? The answer is simple. No, they don't. And they just sound like a bunch of whiny bitches up there bitching and moaning. What did Nancy Pelosi say? That fucking dingbat? I'm surprised she even knows where she is. What did she say? Oh, Trump's a vampire lurking in the night.
And she said, and you know what's fucked up? I'm really pissed off that she did that because I woke up in the middle of the night and I had this dream that I had a dream of four vampires. Like, it was really weird.
You must have eaten some bad chicharrones or something.
Yeah.
But look, what did that Chris Matthews guy say? He said that, you know, Trump's like, you know, hitting his chest like a simian. Let me tell you something about Chris Matthews on MSLSD, okay? If Obama were to whip it out and tell Chris Matthews, hey, suck it, he wouldn't even get halfway through saying that sentence because Chris Matthews would be down there. He'd be cupping the balls. He'd be...
Yeah, like that.
He'd be sucking the shit out of fucking Obama. Okay, we're not doing the dick sucking sound effects that much, okay? I'm not fucking Bubba the Love Sponge here.
We just heard him for like the first time.
That guy's fun.
Yeah, he was fun.
I heard him on the I-Man show.
Yeah.
On the I-Man.
We don't
morning.
Get to catch Imus anymore because he's on so fucking early. Like, you gotta get up at 4 in the morning here to catch.
I like to sleep in. I like to sleep in.
But yeah, that guy's pretty. He's pretty raunchy, man. He's like really deplorable.
Yeah, but he's not as deplorable as us. Anyway, I'm done giving a plug to some degenerate that has chicks literally finger bang themselves in his studio.
Yeah, it's fucking gross.
Right. It's pretty crazy. But isn't Trump kind of like the president that you could call a bro? I mean, I look at Trump and I'd be like, yo, what's up, bro? Like, I kind of look at him as a bro. He's pretty cool.
He is such an amazing image for America.
He won me over with that Palace Idiot Act. No more money for you, Palace Idiots. He won me over again. I'm pro-Trump all over
again.
He's
such a great speaker. I don't care if he dumbs down his speech. He's still captivating.
And you know what else? I want Kim Jong-un to rule the day. Okay? Whether he's a clone, whether he's there, whether it's his brother. I just want North Korea to be wiped off the fucking map!
Yeah, well...
How dare they think they could blow up the White House, even in propaganda. I mean, that's it. That's it. You know, sign me up. That's it. Oh, didn't I try? I remember I tried to fight for a W once. They wouldn't let me in. I guess I didn't pass their algebra test. I was writing Shakespeare and other shit. I was like, oh, well, wait, I'll correct myself. Francis Bacon.
Uh-huh.
That's for all you people that are in the know.
Well, you think your math skills have to be high just in case they need to, like, you know, like for scuba diving, for example, if you were you have to have certain math skills. They, like, have you measure, like, because I got my scuba diving license, and they, like, you know, you have to be able to calculate certain things. They might have you on a mission. They might have to do you mathematical. And it was great that you didn't go.
Yeah, you know, I wanted to get out there and shoot a towel head, you know, get a gun. Yeah, it sounded intriguing at the time. But I started a rock band instead. Anyway, Jia Jia caught me in the bathroom naked the other day looking at a picture of Julia. It's not what it sounds. Okay, you know, the Italian sports car. I was sitting on the toilet. You know, I was pretending to drive it naked. And she caught me. And the fantasy ended. It ended, actually, before when I looked at her. Julia was just done telling me to put my pants on because I was stinking up her fine black leather seats like butt.
Yeah. She didn't say, baby, you can drive my car.
Yeah, something like that. But you get mad every time that Alfa Romeo commercial comes on because she's like, you know, they got like erotic music. And then she's like, oh, see you around, big boy.
What do you think about the new Teslas that are supposed to be in LA and then.
What do I think about the new Teslas?
Self driving. That's at the end of the year. They're going to have self driving Teslas.
I like Nikola Tesla.
But they'll go between L.A. and New York City. So what is the fuck? You can, like, it's like instead of taking a train, you could, like, sit back in the back of a car and just the car will drive you. I mean.
That sounds pretty wild.
It's weird. I wouldn't trust. What the fuck? Do you trust that shit? You'd be like, yo, slow down.
I don't know. But as soon as the Bruce Montalvo show takes over Fox News because the liberals are going to take them out. You know, we saw it on The Simpsons the other day. Remember, it was like a book called Killing Hannity. Had Bill O'Reilly in the back about to stab Hannity. So, I mean, Fox News' days are numbered. So as soon as they go down, I mean, I already beat them on TalkStream Live some days. And you know, Greg Butfeld steals all my shows. I mean, all my freaking words and everything I say.
You're a template for Gutface.
Yeah, Buttface. So, yeah, as soon as I become a big, successful, rich Bruce, I'm going to buy me Julia. That's right. Oh, Jaja's getting jealous.
No, it's okay.
It's okay.
So what about the Pope who...
the Pope.
The Pope. Didn't he talk? Did a TED talk?
He did a TED talk. He said, if I recall, he said that power is like drinking gin. A bouncer couldn't have said it better himself.
Oh my God.
I mean, literally, folks, do you realize... Do you realize that we are run by oligarchical psychopaths? Despots ruling the world, okay? Trump is just the manager at Burger King, yo. Okay? I know this. That's why I'm pro-Trump all over again. I'm not pro his administration, but I'm pro-Trump.
Yeah, but he's slowing down immigration, okay? So, I mean, the regulations are up high, and these motherfuckers at the borders have to follow him, okay? Or they're going to be fired one at a time.
So they're not going to build the wall after all? They're not going to have the moat with the crocodiles?
There's nothing.
Oh, because the Mexicans, they're pretty crazy. I mean, they'll take those crocodiles, make belts and fucking shoes out of them and shit. I mean, maybe you don't want the crocodiles there because, you know, the crocodiles will be threatened by the Mexicans.
Yeah.
Hell, they might even eat them.
Did you see that wall?
Fucking savage.
That, like, end of the wall? It was, like, hysterical.
It was really retarded. But look, folks, we live in a world where totalitarians have us juggle lunacy and insanity. Okay? If you go back and you read Brave New World, it tells you everything, folks. I mean, you wonder why they have, you know, the stupid menages singing about riding dick like a tricycle to little children, right? Well, in Brave New World, they actually have elementary school kids have sex. And then they put them through this Pavlovian conditioning where they put them in a room filled with books and flowers, and then behind some freaking wall, some Nazi scientist, yeah, he freaking pulls the switch and, like, this horrible sound is emitted, so therefore they're conditioned to not like books and flowers
in
this world. I mean, you know, it was called the DHC. It reminded me of the DNC. I mean, that's who Hillary Clinton works for, literally, right out of Brave New World. Okay,
now you know how
it's not in the future. It's now.
Yeah, but now you can see how Clockwork Orange, you know, was where they went through that conditioning, where it came from. You know, they definitely experimented, you know.
Oh, that's the MK Ultra, the mind control, MK. I mean, that comes right out of fucking Nazi Germany. And I hear all you low intellect bastards, oh, you think everything is Nazis because you're stupid. Okay, it's not the Godwin theory, okay? Half of you dumb fucks don't even know that the Nazis won World War II because the Jesuits and the Catholic Church allowed them to escape to places like Argentina and Brazil. And now I even have fucking friends there, and they don't know it, but they're descendants of Nazis.
They know it. They did.
Oh, they know. They fucking know. They're probably listening right now. Big fuck you goes out to that retarded Forrest Gump-looking cocksucker. That's right. I got a lot of... Well, I don't know how you could be my friend. I just called him a cocksucker.
But speaking of Brazil.
Brazil.
You know that they had a huge protest today. The first major one in Rio de Janeiro.
And you know, places like Brazil and Venezuela, they proved that socialism doesn't work. Look at what's happening right now. But go on.
Yeah, they had a police clash. The first in general in strike. Brazil protesters, police clash in first general strike in decades. So they torched buses. Ew, it was in Sao Paulo. But yeah, they torched buses and clashed with police in several cities.
You know, and they want to bring that here. Those Antifa pussies want to bring that kind of crap here. I mean, you see how they were rioting during the anniversary of the LA riots at Berkeley recently, all over again. It's a bunch of leftist pussies, a bunch of liberal fascists out there. I mean, they're pussies. Okay, they don't even know if they're a girl or a guy or in between. I mean, really, bro? Really? I'll kick your fucking ass, all right? I'll rip your balls off and shove them in your fucking mouth. That way you know that you had balls. How about that? That way you feel the pain that I feel every day.
What about that, speaking of ballless men, what do you think about that interview on Five with Caitlin and Tucker?
Oh, I think Fucker Carlson has no balls because he let Caitlin Jenner rub her schlunts all over his face.
He sounded awful, and I think he still has...
Did you see his lips were, like, falling off his face? Like, duh, well, Tucker, I think I'm going to run for office again. Really?
I think the Olympics are, I'm really just for it.
Yeah, I don't care. I don't care that that girl cheated and she's turning into a guy and still fought girls. It's fine.
The Olympic Committee is so far ahead of everyone.
I was on a Wheaties box once. A long time ago. So, you know, and I'm a money grubbing fuck.
That
actually killed a person. And my family and my son-in-law are all pieces of human dog shit.
But doesn't Tucker look like Jenner a little bit?
Yeah. Yeah. Mr. fucking Bowtie looks just like Caitlyn Jenner.
They do. They have like a family resemblance. I wonder if it's his like uncle or his cousin. They seem too at home with each other too. Like it was too easy for him to get. Why doesn't Tucker get other stars? Why'd he get that one? You know what I'm saying? What relevance, what importance does
either he's head over heels like the Trix rabbit is for his cereal over trannies, or he's fucking related to Caitlyn Jenner Bender.
Yeah, there's something fishy there going on, I think. And he definitely got an in.
No, but look, folks, you see that in Brave New World as well. Okay, the sexualization of society, the hypersexualization, you know, things, monsters, like Caitlyn Jenner being put out like actual people that you should, like, you know, give a flip about. Really, really, I mean, the dystopian future of Brave New World is now, okay? Soon, I mean, totalitarians will outlaw books. I mean, they're already outlawing conservative speakers on campuses, okay? What's next? Like I said, flowers. Okay, they're going to make babies start having sex in elementary school. It's just like Brave New World. We're living it. Okay? And here's what I truly think should happen at Berkeley. Okay? I hope they bring out the fucking National Guard out there to smash those Berkeley commies until their head juice comes out. Okay? All right? And those obstructionist Democrats, okay, their affinity for sandbagging Trump has to end. I mean, the American people have to support Trump. They really do. I mean, forget about his cabinet. Support the man.
Yeah, I want to, I was just pretty much in shock when I saw a friend of mine's post. She said something about Trump, and she absolutely made no sense. She was, and she got like 100 people agreeing with her. And she was just making no sense. She's just screaming about stupid shit. She doesn't like his support of Marie Le Pen. Who gives a
fuck? Let me tell you, arguing with liberals is like arguing with a chimpanzee who's flinging his shit all over the place. It doesn't matter what you tell him. He's going to keep flinging shit all over the place because that's what they do. That's what liberals do.
It's just unbelievable how they can talk and talk and not say anything. I mean, this is what she said. I'm going to just read what she said to show you how stupid a person is and how
stupid these liberal snowflakes can be.
She says, "I am so continuously horrified and outraged with Trump's attempt to destabilize this country. Today they announced the plan to dismantle national sacred land and indigenous sites.
Such
ultimate disrespect supporting fascist Marie Le Pen's speech that makes
Wait. Do these idiots realize that they're protesting over here about, oh, the first woman president. Oh, do they realize that Marie Le Pen would be the first woman president of France?
Yeah.
Do they?
Yeah. They don't even see it. I saw like some naked lady running and like some supposed feminist, you know, protesting again.
You know, and it's not good. Let's shift gears here. It's not good because Trump has a problem child. Okay. We know North Korea is acting like a problem child on the world stage, on the flat earth stage. But Trump has Ivanka Trump. That's his problem child. Okay, we didn't elect Ivanka Trump, okay? We don't give a fuck what color lip gloss she puts on, okay? She wants more Syrian refugees to come to America. What do you think of that?
Oh, no. Oh, hell
no. Oh, no, bro.
I'm tired of saying shukran. Okay, because I'm respectful to other people's difference.
She's tired of saying shukran.
Okay, you know, I just came from Brooklyn, and the fucking Yemenites, who I was so nice with.
So many bed bugs on their beds. Anyway, go on.
So supportive and so sweet with them, and as soon as I said I was leaving, they were, like, smiling.
No, I'll never forget it. I wanted to, like, jump over the counter and beat the living dog shit out of this fucking Arab when he said, "Oh, don't come back." Like they run Brooklyn now. Like they're running the whole damn show.
Yeah.
You know, if I was president, there would not be one fucking Syrian refugee in this fucking country. Period. End of story.
Okay, you know, I have a friend who's
from America first. Americans first.
Unless you have something to offer this country, why are we taking in low-level idiots? I have a friend, Isa. He's a fabulous photographer, as an art gallery, and I was going to have a show in Aleppo before we went in there. And, you know, this guy is super well-educated, speaks perfect English, has super many manners. He supports artists. You know, that's a classy person. That's who you bring in. You don't bring in these scums who don't know how to freaking function in our society.
And check this out. Okay, they believe in, like, heaven, right? Allah heaven. Right? They go and they have their 72 versions, which are really like 72 demons, more than likely, because they're fucking evil Satan lovers. And Mohammed was a Satanist, or if he even existed at all, which I doubt he did. You know, don't they have extreme vetting in heaven? Don't they have a wall in heaven? So what the fuck's the big problem, bitch? Every country needs to have a wall, okay? Every freaking neighbor believes in their little white picket fence. Oh, you said white picket fence. That's racist. Yeah, you're being racist.
Yeah, no, it's not cool. I mean,
Mike Tyson does cameos on the
show.
I'm also
different, but you know what? If you want to strive to be the best, you don't let in shit. And it used to be like that. I can't go to France and say I want to be a French freaking citizen. You know?
You hear that? And let me tell you something. I'm going to run for president in 2020. Yeah. I mean, no. I'm going to run for president after Trump's done, because then we're going to be in problems. Okay? I'm better to know. What would that be? 2024 or something? That's right. And you know what my theme song's going to be? I'll play it for you. I'll play you the theme song right now. Bruce Man.
You were helped by a guy wearing the same shirt as you the other day. That was like amazing, and it was a Batman.
Why don't you explain to them what happened? Because I just like lost my voice singing Bruce Man.
Well, Bruce and I were doing laundry. Okay, we don't have.
Yeah, that's what we do. Look, we do gym, we do tan, and we do laundry. Okay, that's our life. Yeah, that's how we live.
And instead of, like, you know, taking off or doing something, Bruce decided to put in the iPad.
I did the stupidest thing. I was listening to Butt Haircut, a.k.a. Hannity.
And Laura.
Ingram. Okay, good combo punch. And our fucking battery went out. Yeah, I could have sworn I was, like, stoned or something. I was like, what was I thinking? I just, you know. But anyway, keep going.
Yeah, and then, like, we just thought, like, what the fuck? And it was getting kind of late. And this guy just, like, helped us. And he had a Batman shirt on. And just like you. It was really funny. And he was so cool.
That's right. He was so cool. He was so cool that I'm going to call him Coolo. Just kidding. He wasn't a Coolo. But anyway, folks, you're listening to the dandiest, most rootin' tootin' fucking show on... On Fridays, you're listening to the Bruce Montalvo Show.
And if Carlos
with Bruce and Jaja,
I doubt he's listening.
Carlos doesn't listen to the Bruce Montalvo Show, but he should, because he would learn English better. Okay. Anyway, Ivanka Trump. I told you, problem child. She wants Syrians. Okay. Bruce Man ain't having that. Okay. I'm gonna pow right in the kisser these motherfuckers. Look. She even got Jesse Waters fired or on leave. What did he say? He said Ivanka handles the mic like a cock without saying it. He said he was turned on by the way she like flicks her little tongue on the microphone like a snake.
That was estupido.
It was so estupido because, yo, isn't he Bill O'Reilly's protege? And didn't they just shit can Bill O'Reilly for supposedly... you know, like touching chicks' butts and stuff. I doubt he likes chicks. He looks more like a fucking pedophile to me. I also heard that Nancy Pelosi has a
pizza joint. Isn't that quite suspicious?
She does?
A little birdie told me on Twitter.
Her and her P2 fucking lodge?
Yeah.
Maybe that's why she's incomplete.
Incomplete. Well, she's incomplete because she has half a fucking brain.
Yeah.
Anyway, do you see the power of the liberals? The power of their dark side. Yo, these liberals, when they get triggered, nobody's safe. Not even Jesse Waters. Fucking, it ain't his Waters world anymore. He's sitting at home freaking spanking his monkey.
Yeah, I mean.
But didn't he interview Trump? I mean, that is such an unclassy and disrespectful thing to do. What a stupid fucktard. You just had Trump on your show. Trump, El Trumpo, El Gran Trump, says himself to Stupid Waters, who is now in Hot Waters.
Yeah.
He says, you have a promising career.
That is so.
And then he turns around and talks about his daughter giving BJs on the mic.
So disrespectful. I mean, I could see.
Really low class.
Literally. I could see Bubba the Love Sponge, who probably will never, ever meet Donald Trump and have an interview with him. Just because of who he is.
You know what Bubba the Love Sponge would say? He would say that Ivanka would shove the whole mic up her pussy.
And he could get away with it because he's not in any respectable position where he's going to actually interview Trump. But he probably, a guy like him would probably be like, I'll never meet the guy anyway. I'll just say what the hell I want and exercise my free speech. But this guy's on mainstream media. He just met Donald. You know, why is he that immature that he's got to just slip up and okay, he's got the hot one. Just say she's very beautiful.
So you hear me? Jesse Waters, who is on Hot Waters, has made it to my weenies and wusses segment because that was pretty weenie to say, right? Hey, does he actually think he has a chance with Ivanka? I mean, what's he fantasizing about? He's got a better chance with Ann Coulter's ugly ass.
I know. Who's always up in there.
That's right. So he's made it to my illustrious weenies and wusses segment. Actually, a friend of mine that I know that is related to Nazis should be on the weenies and wusses segment. And I don't want to give him any press because, you know, he's a...
No, he gave you press. Don't give him press.
That's
he's
right.
Nobody.
That's right. You're a nobody. Nobody fucking knows you, all right? Nobody gives a fuck about you. You live in your mommy's basement, okay? You're spanking your fucking sausage in your mommy's basement, and you call it a podcast. You're a fucking joke, bro. And I know you're related to fucking Nazis, and that's a fact because I get intel. So, both of them, Jesse Waters and one of my douchebag friends that's related to Nazis, made it to my weenies and wusses segment.
Wow.
That's right. And the video of the week is a cat getting freaked out by a fucking laser light, you know. That's what they want us to act like when it comes to North Korea. Oh, they got the Kwan Yongsang 4 up there. They want us to freak out like that cat. But you're not freaking out. Why? Because you learned to be like Dr. Strangelove and...
Stop worrying and love the bomb.
That's
and
right.
Just think of it as Google Santa.
That's right. Google Santa. That's right. Google fucking Santa. You know who's making it on my butthole of the week list? Paul Ryan. Why is Paul Ryan still around? Why is he still the House, Speaker of the House? Let me tell you something about Paul Ryan. Paul Ryan is as useless as tits on a boar. I mean, can't they see that he's still working for the Obamas? He's an Obama holdover. Get him the fuck out of there. Okay? Get him out of there like the Empire. Speaking of the Empire, yo, I saw this one sports play because, you know, I'm going to give you the inside baseball on this. This guy literally, he jumped over the fucking catcher onto the home plate. That was the craziest sports play I've ever seen. He must have been watching our video of the week and he saw that cat jump all over the place. That's what happened. So that's the butthole of the week and the video of the week all crammed into one. That's right. Paul Ryan, as useless as tits on a boar. And you know what's even more useless? CNN. I mean, they got these anchors like Jake Tapwater, okay, and the powdered shit donut, Don Lemon, or Mr. Hankey, the Christmas poo stunt double, Juan Williams, okay? They just haven't helped. Those are the guys that are hell-bent on overthrowing Fox News. I mean, they're like liberal insiders in Fox News that literally want us to believe that Trump's the bad guy. Trump's the bad guy. I mean, why are they even on Fox News? They're not conservatives. They're liberal scum.
Yeah, they're everywhere, you know. I mean, they've had their jobs and they're actors.
I mean, they're just as insane as Pelosi and McCain. I think Pelosi and McCain should have their own sitcom. Or they should just start dating and fuck each other even more insane.
Yeah, I'd love
the two of them are fucking crazy.
Talk about a power couple, and they'd be like a mentally disabled couple.
Oh my god. It'd be like the Legion of Doom for handicapped people.
My god, it would be the funniest thing to see them like hang out. They're probably the only two people in the world that understand each other.
Oh my god. And that's what really annoys me. Every time I see Nancy Pelosi on the TV, that really annoys me. That's what really annoys me, folks. But guess what? It's that time. It's that very special time for Bruce's very special, very wonderful top 10 list that I stole from you-know-who, David Letterman. Yeah, who's he? Nobody cares anymore, David. You're done. It's Bruce's time to shine. Anyway, number 10, North Korea tests ballistic missile amid reports of Pyongyang starting war. U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, who kind of looks like a pedophile too, warned earlier on Friday that failure to curb North Korea's nuclear and ballistic missile programs could lead to a total all-out war. Isn't that nice? Why don't you eat Smacky Smalls too? That's right. So, Kim Jong-un, who suffers from projectile dysfunction, is huffing and puffing. He's got troops on the beach. He's firing off freaking missiles on his tanks and everything. I mean, does he not realize that we're going to fucking blow him away after he tested his missile today? He's done. Whatever's ruling North Korea, they're finished. I feel bad for the people. Okay, there's got to be some type of humanitarian effort to get the people out of there before we rain total fucking bedlam, before it rains shit on North Korea. Don't you agree?
Yeah.
The effort has to be made. Something's got to happen. I mean, China's probably going to be tripping because they're going to have all sorts of North Korean refugees, you know, leaving and coming into the country because that country is about to be toast. They're done.
You know, unless they are just a mock country where China uses them to test their own weaponry.
So you're telling me that North Korea literally is like Dennis Rodman, who is like the rebounder for the Chinese version of the Chicago Bulls. So he's just getting all their rebounds. He's doing their dirty work for them.
Yeah.
Wow. Number 9, Fox loses shine. Sean Hannity, a.k.a. Butt Haircut, warns of whispers of new network. The thing about starting a new network, you see the liberals are trying to destroy the only outlet that actually gives Trump a fair shot. I mean, you see all the other outlets. All of them hate Trump. On Fox is the only network that you get some fair and balanced coverage of Trump. They're the only network that's not calling him a vampire. Juan Williams is, and all the other douchebags. They got a couple of douchebags on Fox News that shouldn't be there. They should go back to CNN or where the fuck rock they crawled out of. But this is bad. This is bad. Sean Hannity defends executive as Fox News turmoil continues. You see, the one TV network where Trump gets a fair shot, they want silence. They want talk radio silenced. They want shows like ours silenced. Why? Because not only do we expose the whole truth and nothing but the truth here on this show, at least, because
as much as we can offer.
Because Fox News is forked tongue faux news, okay? Okay, it sounds like they're on your side. Oh, Fox and Friends. Oh, they're my friend. They're not. They really are not. Okay?
They're watching you while you're having sex. They're watching you when you're getting undressed.
You really want me to tell that story?
I guess so.
Oh, God. So me and Jaja are about to do the hibbity-dibbity the other day. And right before I entered her awesomeness, a commercial comes on, and it sounded like this. Playboy TV.
Out of nowhere.
I was like, holy shit, are you looking at my butt cheeks right now?
I was like, are they looking at us for ideas, or are they just looking at us to get off?
Let me tell you something, folks.
Are we there, Playboy TV, or they want us to subscribe?
Yo, but we were wearing, it wasn't even that sexy. I mean, you weren't, like, you know, sexed up or wearing all that lingerie I like. We were just like, you know, whatever, you know? I'm saying, we had, like, big shirts on or whatever. And it's just ridiculous.
Because we know that their fucking TV's watching us all the time, so, you know, like, we just... I don't really, like, pull everything. I don't know. I'm a little shy.
She's shy. She's shy, folks. You know, it was weird, I'll tell you that, okay? Because, you know, it was just weird. I mean, it was a trip. Okay, how about we move on? Because she's so red. She's blushing, folks. Okay?
It happened. It's true.
That's right. Know. It's true. It's all true.
Yeah, that's our hot sex moment for the day.
That's right. That's, yeah. Okay, let's continue, please. Number 8, exclusive. Trump says major conflict with North Korea possible. Look, before I talk about that, do you realize that I have scored with a chick on TV? That's right. That has nothing to do with the top 10 list. I have scored with a chick on TV. How many of you listening to this show can honestly say you have scored with a chick that has been on TV? Let me tell you something. I'm going to make sure they inscribe that on my fucking tombstone when I die, when I'm 1,000 years old.
Because you'll get that life extension, right?
Oh, I'm going to be a robot. Uh-huh. I made up my mind. I want to be a robot for a couple of years. I want to be like fucking, you know, the T-1000. Or what's that other one? Ed 109. It could be Bruce 105 or something. Anyway, back to the article here. Number 8, exclusive. Trump says major conflict with North Korea possible. U.S. Presidente Donald Trump says on Thursday, he said major conflict with North Korea is possible in the standoff over its nuclear missile programs. And you see him looking very seriously out the window. He's got a lot on his plate. You know, he turned into emo Trump today. He says, you know, it's not as easy as I thought it would be. You know, I miss my old life. You know, he, on his 100th, in one day in office, I think it was Melania's birthday, he wished her a very happy birthday. You know what I'm saying? Now, they did the whole Easter egg thing, and he even called out the Easter bunny. He said, you're a creepy motherfucker, you know that? And he is. That Easter bunny, the big-ass glasses and shit. I mean, that is a Egyptian black magic fertility ritual for you dumbasses that don't know. Ishtar, Easter. Anyway. Major conflict with North Korea. Are they just saber rattling? Again, Dr. Strangelove, how I learned to love the freaking bomb from the Gap Band.
Well, obviously, Russia is not our enemy, okay?
Well, Russia said this whole thing is a bunch of malarkey. It's a bunch of phony baloney, just posturing fucking dog and pony show shit.
This is not 1972. The Cold War has, like, been over, and even that was a fucking
It's like show. You said, we need another boogeyman.
Yeah, well, they tried to make Russia the boogeyman, okay? This doesn't work, okay? If our NASA is over in Moscow, they cannot be the boogeyman.
And I'm going to break the top 10 list for a while because you're right. They tried to make Russia the boogeyman, and Trump exposed it himself. He said, totally made up story. He said that today. As the first 100 days wind down, Trump says Russia's story was made up. Trump, the Democrats pushing Fox faux Russia story to feel better about losing election, and the fucking most communist, libtarded outlet that works for George/Darth Soros, Media Matters. I hate those bastards. Trump praises Fox for being fair, unlike every other network. So Trump's saying it again. It's all a bunch of fake fucking shit, and get over it, because... Russia, the Russia story is fake. It's a bunch of recycled bullshit. That's what it is.
I'll tell you what's not fake. U.S. Marines could deploy robots and hypersubs to storm future beaches.
Wow.
Yeah, these robots can have, like, all kinds of machine guns and, you know...
Whoa, it'll be just like fucking Terminator and shit.
Yeah, for the past 2 weeks, the Navy and Marine Corps have been quietly testing about 50 new fascinating technologies at Camp Pendleton.
Camp Pendleton.
Ship to shore, maneuver exploration, and experimental...
I knew a couple of shills that came out of Camp Pendleton.
Yeah, I don't think this is really a shill.
Number 6, Trump returns to the NRA, which backed him early and often in 2016. Remember the first time that Trump met with the NRA and he was holding that gun or whatever?
Yeah, we were in
in Trump Tower. We were having a Taco Bowl.
There was nobody in that place.
It was so dead when we went.
We went there and checked it out, you know, and I've been there before, but it used to be really different back, you know, like 15 years ago. But
back in the day.
Yeah, and then we went there and it was like kind of musky and kind of dusty and nobody was really in it. And
the Taco Bowl was good.
Yeah, it was delicious. And, we went to see the jewelry store. I mean, that's what I kind of...
Tiffany's? Oh, my God. I was, like, drooling. I was like, bleh.
No, Ivanka's.
The problem child. Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. Right. Number four. Senator Ted Cruz introduces bill to make Mexican pay for the wall. That's right. El Chapo. El Chapo, a.k.a. Super Mario Brother, who likes to dig tunnels and shit and escape.
You asked me before if I...
They want him to pay for the wall with all his drug money.
You asked me if...
I think it's a good idea.
You asked me if I thought that Trump was going to do it. And I'm going to say yes, because there's nothing that Trump says that he's going to do that he's not going to do.
Trump's a man of his word. Look, he got busy from day one in office, okay? He deserves more respect than a dumbass who just went out golfing. Not to mention all the fucking billions he stole from the American people. Why isn't that motherfucker in jail yet? I mean, we have confirmation that he spied on Trump associates and he wiretapped Trump Tower. I mean, the president himself exposed Barry, the Palestinian lover. Why the fuck is he not in jail yet?
No, he got a $400,000 book deal today.
Unbelievable. Yeah. Oh, my God.
So Bill Ayers can write his other book.
I'm doing the face palm right now. You see it?
Yeah. I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, you know he's not even a writer. Is the whole book going to be...
It's going to be about Barry O slamming H, okay, Hussein, in between his fat fucking toes. Number three. North Korea releases chilling new video showing White House blowing up. Wow. A propaganda outlet issued the footage shortly after the U.S. announced that it was sending warships to the Korean Peninsula. That's some scary propaganda. Yo, Kim Jong-un, you know, he's saying he's got some big cojones. You know what I'm saying?
Looks like he's been gaining weight.
Probably been eating a lot of Swiss cheese. I heard that's... Why don't they poison his fucking quesadilla? Can someone please poison Kim Jong-un's quesadilla to spare us, you know, the trouble of having to nuke them into fucking the netherworld? I mean, really? It says here, White House and North Korean crosshairs in video mock-up. Here we have number two. Left-leaning Ivanka becoming Donald Trump's problem child. She says admitting Mideast migrants has to be part of the discussion. Really, Ivanka? Really, are you going to go to the swimming pools and swim in the swimming pools where these disgusting leishmaniasis-filled Syrians are going to be swimming in? Are you going to be shopping at the same shopping centers where these living, breathing Mr. Hankies from Somalia who don't even know what toilet paper is, who don't even know what a toothbrush is. Actually, they know what toilet paper is. It's their hand that they wipe their ass with. And then they make you a mocha latte at fucking Starbucks or whatever, right? Are you going to go to that Starbucks with the guy that's wiping his ass with his hand, Ivanka? Is she?
Yeah.
This is bad news.
Yeah.
Problem child.
Again, I don't have a problem child. With immigrants. I just please, you know, we're a first world. We're not trying to go down to second world.
It's about taking steps forward, not taking like five for freaking 19 steps back.
Well, 3 - 2. You know, I mean, what they did was that they tried to bring the third world into America, which is the first world. 3 - 1 = 2. So a second world is a combination, which is what they were trying to do. They were trying to make us into a fucking... By influxing so many immigrants, third world immigrants, it will bring down our standards. You know what? our education standards are low enough. These people are fucking stupid.
Have you seen how stupid the Palestinians are? Oh, Palestinians are beyond stupid. Really? Really? Linda Sour? Huh? Oh, I deserve a right to exist. Look, you could deserve a right to exist in Jordan, where your ass belongs, because that's where fucking Palestine always was and always will be. Okay? Israel was called Judea and Samaria. You stupid bastards! Don't make me join the IDF! I'll kill you myself! You hear that? Be me, I'm coming. They need help. They need all the help they can get. And with that, number one is Palestinian leaders. BB said this. Palestinian leaders teaching their children to murder Jews. Don't take my word for it. Just watch it. I mean, I played clips.
No.
I played clips
of
that.
They do say that. I've been seeing it for years.
And when I say I'll kill you myself, I'm talking about fighting in the IDF, because there's probably somebody out there saying that, whatever, right? They want
to
twist my words.
No, he means he's there.
I mean that I'm going to join the fucking IDF, and I'm going to fucking cross the eyes of whoever they tell me to go fucking, you know, take out and shit.
But you might not pass their algebra test.
Damn it.
And you probably have to speak a little bit of Old Testament. Baruch atah Adonai
Eloheinu. Shalom. There you go. There you go. Mazel tov. Matzah balls. Yarmulke.
Hey, Shabbat shalom.
That's right. Hey, Shabbat shalom to everybody listening, all our Jewish friends in Brooklyn, because that's like little Israel. That's like Israel part two, isn't it?
There are Jews everywhere. Not a lot, but there's Jews.
Okay, folks. That's the top 10 list.
Yeah.
In a nutshell right there.
Hey, I have a health moment.
It's Jaja's health moment.
Yeah. I see on CNN they're asking, is Sissy healthy? And then they kind of bring up the, you know, how it's like good, like the avocados.
Oh, sushi is very good. Yeah, you eat it and you don't know that we are secretly plotting to kill you. Oh, yeah.
Can I tell you how many liver flukes are in sushi? Can I tell you how many diseases that it causes? Raw seafood.
Go ahead and tell him. Go ahead and tell him.
As much as I ate it and loved it, this shit will fucking. There's like five. There are liver flukes. Colon ocus, sinensis, opus thorchis, viverini, and opus thorchis felini.
I don't know what language you're speaking. Are you speaking Filipino like I was earlier in the show?
Yes, close enough. All right. These things will fucking kill you. They'll eat away at your liver, your bile ducts. You won't even know it. The doctors will come in.
Bad news. Bad news, folks.
You have a little bit of cholesterol coming that's like not right. Yo, how much sushi did you eat? Okay, that's the question. Bruce and I got some of this stuff actually called Huma Worm, and we're just like hoping that we'll be able to like rid ourselves completely of any parasites, because people are filled with them. We have 12 to 13 at least. That's the average person has 12 to 15 or so parasites in their body, and they find themselves in your stomach, and then they move around your.
So you know what? There's a good product out in the market made by our good friend Bill Hicks. Just buy that liver shield.
Yeah, we bought it actually.
Buy it from him, because you know what? That bitch of an ex-wife he has is probably taking all his money right now. So you gotta help him. You gotta help my good friend Bill.
Yeah, he even has like signed guitars or something on his.
I wish I could buy that.
On his eBay.
But I would buy it on one condition, that he actually signed it as Bill Hicks. That would rule. Anyway, folks, the Sword of Damocles moment is here. Or is it? Are we supposed to love the bomb? An EMP, as we talked about, possibly shut down the grid in L.A., New York, San Francisco, and no one cared. They all went to sleep. They all ate their Chips Ahoy cookies, drank their milk, and didn't question a damn thing. Okay, war. What is it? What is it good for? Absolutely nothing, right? War is the bread and butter of the elite. They make money making bombs, implementing regime change, and you stay in your cubby, scared out of your mind. That's simple, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. They want you in fear. In fear of something, of not doing. So much in fear that you can't do anything.
So much in fear that you can't use your even your own mind. Okay, the political use of psychology, okay, needs to be stopped. All these liberal snowflakes out there, they need to be, they need to be, I don't want to take away their freedom of speech, but, you know, if they keep breaking freaking windows or whatever, destroying their campuses, they need to be slapped with a billy club. All of them, okay?
I can't imagine paying for school to learn how to riot. That's fucking retarded. Okay, oh yeah, I wanted to tell you, to tie it in with that girl's post. She started complaining how come nobody's rioting enough.
Oh,
and
God.
And they should be out there every day.
Oh, God.
Who has time to be out there organizing against their false ideals?
Oh, okay? They got plenty of time if they're getting paid by George Soros to do it.
It was just retarded. I can't believe she's like, oh.
MoveOn.org, all those groups are linked to Soros.
We should be out there protesting all the time.
Protesting what? Just because Madonna's remedial fucking retarded old fucking crow's feet having ass said, I am too from the White House.
Our house is white. Does she want
to
blow us up too?
Bring it, bitch! I'll make a fucking potato launcher and shoot in between your fucking camel toe. How about that?
Well, maybe Melania should have been singing, I'm burning up for your love.
No, pretty much, I will rip my shirt off. I'll rip my shirt off. I would rip this shirt off right now if I didn't like it. Okay, it's my Wolverine shirt from X-Men. But look, what are you going to do when Montalvo Mania runs wild on you? Okay, in 2024, I'm going to run for fucking president.
Mm-hmm. And the Libertarian Party.
I don't know. I don't like Gary Johnson. And libertarians never win. They get like 1% of anything anywhere. I don't know. Probably with the big elefantes. How about... Not that one, actually. Oh, my God. I take it back. Elephant. I meant elephant, not elephantes. Right. The Pizzagate pedo.
You meant like...
The, you know, I'm trying to switch up, you know, mix up the Mexican or the Spanish with the English. And,
right.
And, you know, I didn't think about that one. Mm-hmm. Elefante.
Yeah, I was like, wait. You're saying you don't mean that.
You know what I just realized? I realized that when I get super old and eventually this marvelous body of mine dies, I hope that God shows himself to me as Hulk Hogan. That's right. Wouldn't that be cool? Wouldn't that be cool? I'm like, could you picture that? I'm like being beamed up on the Stairway to Heaven Led Zeppelin talked about. And then the sky opens up and it's fucking Hulk Hogan slash God. That's right, brother. Come in. You're welcome. You did a good job protecting all the Montalvo maniacs, brother. That's how I see heaven.
Okay. I hope you don't go there soon. But I just wanted to mention that there's been like some strange shit going down with
strange shit, folks.
MS-13 and Long Island.
You mean cerotes? Don't call them by their freaking gang name. Call them cerotes. Call them dirty, stinking turds that float in turd bowls.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what Salvadorians are to me. Whenever I hear that, I hear, oh, what, you mean cerote? And I start grabbing my nose like someone just farted.
They're killing people in a town called...
Oh, that's nothing! Redwood. That's nothing!
Long Island?
They're everywhere. They're everywhere.
The people are afraid to go to school.
You know what they do? Redwood. Let me tell you what they do. They have little axes and they hack people to death with axes.
They kill like 13 people.
They should have been taken out the minute they took over Echo Park in LA. Are you fucking kidding me? The minute that I couldn't find a taco in Echo Park and I was surrounded by pupusas, that should have been a fucking warning flag.
And speaking of tacos, don't you want King Taco to like open up here in Tucson?
I don't know about Tucson, but definitely bring their asses to fucking Arizona. I need some King Taco. Look, first of all, I think it's unfair that they're only in California, okay? First of all, California, they think they're their own fucking country now. So, what? I'm going to have to get a fucking passport to go get tacos next? Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay, moving on, folks. Could you believe that, you know, the lying snake fork-tongued media is saying that despite the fact that Trump has a 96 approval rate,
okay, on jobs or you name it. It was 96. They're saying that it's like at an all-time low, 45%. Okay, they are making up stories. Left and right.
That's just that, you know what? Tavistock does that. They come up with fake polls. They've always done that. They just come up with it. They pick it out of the blue and they just decided.
It's just a deranged left-wing propagandist media that they really hate Trump to an unhealthy degree, don't they?
Yeah, it's insane. How could you not like him? He fucking sounds great. I mean, listen, I mean, put him next to Obama. If Palestinians, if Muslims.
Fantastic.
You know, I mean, you put them next to each other, there's no comparison. And it's not color, okay? Because I was behind a Barack Obama. I mean, I dated black guys. It's nothing to do with fucking color. It has to do with your ideology. And Barack had,
listen to me. I had a black girlfriend that my friends called Zimbabwe.
Yeah, that's
she popped my cherry.
You're from California. You guys have like.
But she was like Creole. She was like mocha latte. I don't really like them when they're like as dark as a fucking oil stain in the driveway, okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, that's preference, but you know.
Am I being racist? No. Was that a racist statement?
No, they'll say.
I am such a bigot. I am normalizing hate speech, ain't I?
No, because that's right. I've known black people my whole life and they'll say the same thing. When I was teaching school, art class with like a bunch of black students, and I was teaching them how to paint themselves self portraits, and you know, painting self portraits, you have to teach them how to mix colors, right? So I mean, I had to mix all the shades. They had to, I had to teach all the shades of their skin, you know. And then they got all. You'd see the sensitivities. You know, me, I'm not racist, so I was like, boom, you know, this is how you get your color skin. This is how you get your. You add a little more blue. This is when you have a little more orange. You have a little more, you know, whatever it is. And I would hear the comments I would hear. It was like, oh, my skin is so ugly. It's black. It's so dark. I'm like, what are you talking about? You know, they'll say the same things about
their
own
skin. You know what? Black people are so fucking stupid. And literally, they're like the most racist people there are now. And I'll tell you why they're fucking stupid. Because they're going around babbling about white privilege. That's fucking stupid. Okay? Because I know Nazi descendants that don't live too far from fucking trailer park homes. Where the fuck's their white privilege, huh? You gotta admit, okay, like that guy, that guy with the shades that's on CNN, that comedian or whatever the fuck he says he is, one of the stupidest guys ever. He's interviewing that KKK motherfucker that he doesn't even know the Freemasons and the KKK are like the same thing. Okay, they're both founded by Albert Pike, literally. Okay, but he's interviewing Richard Spencer, a provocateur, and he's sitting there laughing with them, and it looks like they're best friends. You know why? Because black people have become the most racist people in America. They are by far more racist than the KKK, even. I'll go as far and say that.
Wasn't it?
I mean, look, we just came off of 8 years of having a black president. What are they talking about, white privilege? What are they talking about?
Yeah. Really. Meanwhile, you had fake artists.
Deranged.
Yeah, I can't even.
Deranged. Don't even talk about it. Okay. Let me take a sip of my coffee here. That's right. Look, Kim Jong mentally ill. Okay. His fat ass. What was he saying the other day? It sounded funny. All the people on TV. Super mighty preemptive strike. Super mighty preemptive strike. It sounded like fucking the Power Rangers or something. I thought Zordon was saying, a super mighty preemptive strike. Really? I thought I was watching the fucking Power Rangers. Every time I see North Korea, I'm hoping that the Green Ranger will show up with like his flute and make fucking that one Zordon or whatever the fuck he had come out of the water and fight Kim Jong-un. It's like Power Rangers. Don't their weapons look like weapons you would see in Power Rangers?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's a joke. I don't even think they're real missiles. They're like made out of cardboard and shit.
Yeah, they had their little parade, and that was.
Yeah. Oh, communist.
And if there are missiles, then
parades.
They're Chinese owned.
They were given to them by Bill and Hillary Clinton, literally through their fucking goddamn foreign policy that is worth as much as the toilet paper I take a shit on.
Maybe it's an experimental nation. They keep North Korea completely like I said, the boogeyman, but they can, you know, maybe they're seeing how fascist the government can get.
I'll tell you how fascist governments can get. Do you know that in Chechnya right now they're killing and detaining gay men? Okay, just because they like to smoke pole?
That's fucked up.
I don't see the bipartisan big government profiteers of war doing anything about Chechnya.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're so fucking enthralled about, you know, gays and trans and whatnot, what about Chechnya, bro? I haven't heard of Kim Jong-un killing any freaking fruits.
Yeah. I don't know about that
country. That's what we have. Look, we have demonic despots, oligarchical psychopaths pushing their oligopoly of eugenics and profiting off of death and destruction. Plain and simple, okay? This is literally the show that has escaped a soulless Eden.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, I sound like I should be writing a book, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It's a soulless Eden. We are living in a brave new world, okay? It doesn't matter what form of totalitarianism there is, okay? They make you, the propertyless, love your servitude. That's what they want. I mean, you got freaking idiots in trailer parks that have nothing. I love that they're Donald Trump dropping the bombs. I want him to kill more people. Little do they know that probably nobody was killed in Syria. They just, got rid of some old inventory of bombs to help Raytheon's stock go up.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, don't take my word for it. Google it up. Do the research your damn self.
Yeah. They probably want to build up like Dubai kind of thing over there. You know? Like
okay. I don't hate Trump. I don't hate Trump. You know what I hate? I hate the Syria policy that the Trump administration is doing. But at the same time, I've learned to deal with it because it's like flexing our muscles because we had 8 years of a total fucking pussy. So we needed to do something like that. And he dropped the bomb literally in the most humanitarian of ways. And he made money doing it. Something that old dumbass had no idea. Okay, you give old dumbass $2 and he'll be like negative $5.
You know what just pisses me off? That like these Jewish people are still crying for Obama. I'm like,
oh God.
That man hated you. He fucking hated you. Okay, he hated you.
He hated Jew.
Get it? Jew. He did. So
they just sank themselves into the big sleep. Okay, they're sheeple, plain and simple. Now, you know, folks, the god Montalquatl requires a blood sacrifice of baby veal cutlets. I had some of those the other day. I was like making some veal cutlets. They came out pretty good. But you hate when I cook, you know, veal or bison or anything, because I stink up the joint.
Disgusting.
That's Montalvo's cooking minute here. I like to take the little veal cutlets, you know what I'm saying? I make them into a little veal cutlet there.
Ugh.
I have the Italian seasoning,
the first
you know
time
what I'm saying?
Ever let him do
I like
that
to
in
use the olive oil. You know, I put them on there, you know what I'm saying? I've put a slow fire on it, and it's just so delicious. I made these delicious veal sliders, and that's what it was. It was a blood sacrifice to the god, Montalquatl. That's right. I require blood sacrifices of baby veal cutlets, folks. I didn't know if you knew that, but you do! So, what else is going on in the news? Let's see here. What do I got in front of me right here? Let's see.
How about
Tough Times Made Him Do It? NYPD detective caught masturbating in front of children in a yard. So he was rubbing his schmendrick, as friends of mine have said.
Mm-hmm.
A New York NYPD, he was rubbing his schmendrick in somebody's backyard. Wow. That's what makes the news today. So you see, complaints about masturbating on Delta Airlines. You hear that? You hear that, folks? Look, if you like to freaking stroke your beef, don't fly Delta. Don't fly Delta. What else we got here? This is just deplorable, and it proves...
Don't fly Delta.
If you like to jack off, don't fly Delta, because they're getting pretty fucking tough on masturbators.
Oh, Oh, if you're a masturbator, yes.
Oh, God. Can I continue?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm reading about...
Can you stop shilling? Can you stop reading here? I'm reading the next story. It says here, this makes my point for the chair. Okay? This makes my point right here. Arrest made at North Highlands High School. Police arrest teen in sexual assault beating of an 86-year-old woman. You believe that? You believe that? Woman, 86 years old, killed at Highlands High Track, was sexually assaulted. Oh my God, we need the chair. We need the chair. And you know what they need to do? Not only do we need the chair, but they need to fucking pay-per-view it to make some money too. Because this is America, right? We're a fucking capitalist country. Let's make some money. And you order it on the pay-per-view on the Netflix. You see this motherfucker get roasted for raping two old ladies like that. What? Were they wearing Trump shirts? Huh? You fucking piece of shit. I would like to pull the switch on this guy without wetting the sponge.
And speaking of ordering online, you should go to our stores.
Oh, that's right. We haven't promoted. I'm talking about masturbating and raping old ladies and capitalism. So take it away, Jaja.
Right, so you can go to our eBay store right now, and you could just type in eBay Outrageous Jewelry into your Google, and our store will pop up. We're like 3616 or 3620 Outrageous Jewelry, and we have a huge 70% off sale.
Huge.
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 Not
huge.
The whole store, but we have 70% off, 60% off, 50% off.
And if you really want to support, the show, just don't listen. Buy and listen. You hear me? You need to obey. You need to buy. You need to buy and obey.
Consume. Buy jewelry.
Consume.
No, stuff is really awesome. You know, and we have a lot of new things.
Handmade, made in America by yours truly. Okay? We toil over this jewelry every day. Okay? I got splinters the size of the fucking Gibraltar here. Okay, I'm working for you, folks. I'm not a slave. I'm working for me, but I'm working for you to look good.
Yeah, I got those 3D printed pendants with macrame chains. We got sterling silver, big wide cuffs. You know,
one of a kind, beautiful
works of art. I mean, each one is got a little bit of Bruce and Jaja in it. You know what I'm saying? We're like really work it. And we rarely repeat ourselves, and we have a lot of repeat buyers.
Support America First made products, made in America. That's the only way we're gonna keep kicking the rest of the world's ass.
And be different. This is what my philosophy is to make people feel great, have like a statement piece, you know, conversational piece. And you know, and walk away with a wearable piece of art, you know, that's like unique, so you don't look like everybody.
And she's an artist, folks. She's got works all over the world. I mean, coveted works in the Whitney Museum. I mean,
many, many places.
Many, many places.
Many museums, many galleries, many collectors. Although the art world basically stuck their nose up at me because they just...
Well, we know that the art world is probably run by George Soros now, so it's no... It's no, like, you know, biggie why they did it. We know they're a bunch of commie fucks.
Yeah, they're fickle as fuck. There's always, like, 500 new artists every year. And they come out, and then they, like, disappear.
But, you know, you'd figure, since everything right now is about supporting women, that they would support you because you're a woman artist.
Yeah.
But no, they put on freaking mutants that literally mutilated themselves and call themselves a woman. I still sound like this. And they're artists.
Look, I'm the ultimate rebel as a...
They take a picture of a dog taking a shit in the middle of the street, and that's art. Because it was shot by a tranny.
I even had Damien Hirst steal my skull.
Unbelievable.
Okay, I had a Swarovski skull.
You know what I'd like to do to that guy's skull? I want your skull. I need your skull.
Yeah, they just borrow
fucking
ideas.
Love dancing.
The elite want to have their people do well, and then they just fuck people like me up. So my art gallery dealer in Germany, where I had two one-person shows, and I showed
into Germany, yeah.
Yeah, he said to me, you know, Junior, I love your work so much, you know, and I very so much supported it, but And when I was in Germany, he said, you know, I can't sell your work because your name is an American female. If you had a German male's name, you'd be able to sell your shit like hotcakes.
Unbelievable. So, but, you know, we talked it over and we figured that you could probably make more. That was a good thing because you could probably make more money selling it individually. I mean, you were really giving it away. I mean, $5,000 for some of your most prized pieces is really, really a major loss for you.
It would be. I was just like, I just loved him so much, and he's done a lot. I went to Germany a few times. He took me there. He took me to Haiti. You know, we did a lot of stuff.
And speaking of major loss, okay, did you know, folks, that most U.S. manufacturing jobs are being lost to robots? What did we see the other day? That Lobot in Lowe's? Now, I'm not saying we're about to get fucking overrun by robots like most dumbasses out there that put on a tinfoil hat, okay? I got a tinfoil hat. I'm just not wearing it right now. But that's the thing. Look, I know because I've talked to, like, the best freaking people in robotics, the best. I know that we're not going to get overrun by robots, okay? Because we're the ones programming the fucking robots. I mean, we go to pay for something, and you know they got those like electronic robot cashiers or whatever. You know, you do it yourself. How many times do they fuck up? Could you imagine robots running the country? They're gonna fuck up left and right all the time. You know why? Because they're not people, and they're programmed.
Well, that's what I'm saying about those cars. That how the fuck are they gonna put them on the road? The self-driving cars.
Oh, they crash all the time with Uber. That's why Uber got the hell out of Arizona. They wanted to bring self-driving cars here.
I mean, I could see if they're on a path, their own path. You understand? Not our roads, but their own roads, like a train track. If they have, it's kind of like a train kind of thing. If they have that, but they can't start mixing and matching and shit. That's really dangerous because the self-driving cars. How are they gonna determine? It's like a person's decision or indecision. A drunk driver, for example. Are they going to be able to calculate? I don't think it's really that sophisticated yet. I wouldn't trust it.
No. You know, we're not going to hit freaking Terminator 2, okay? Or Rise of the Machines. Because we're the ones programming the robots. They are literally our mindless slaves. They do whatever we want. And for those deviants out there that are hoping that and praying that they're going to have a mate one day because no real human chick likes them and they think they're just going to have a robotic wife one day, dude, do you realize that that robot's supposed pussy has all sorts of gears in it? So if you stick your fucking sausage in there, what happens if one of those gears malfunctions, bro? Off with your dick, right? Or they got gears in the mouth, too. What if you're mouth fucking your robot and one of the gears fucks up? Off with your dick again!
Yeah.
I mean, where are these guys' minds? Where are they? In the gutter, obviously.
You're better off fucking your stuffed animal.
It reminds me of my cat Wesley. How many times I caught that freaking little depraved, degenerate fucking cats? Or, I mean, fucking like the stuffed animal cat or the stuffed bear or whatever.
Yeah, he used to hump the stuffed animals.
Now they cut his balls off now. So at least he got his wiggles out with all the stuffed animals. You know what? They should throw away all those stuffed animals. Now that I think about it. But whatever. Anyway, folks, we're coming.
It's got cat cum on it.
Duh. She's got to be so specific, doesn't she? We're coming down to the end of the show, so let's tackle a couple of more topics here. Look at this. Unbelievable. Obama cashes in. You know, he once said he wasn't working for the fat cats. How many pictures of him do you get where he's laughing his fucking ass off? He is a fat cat piece of shit. Oh, dumbass. Look at this. Obama cashes in, set to take over $400,000 for a speech. For a speech. Less than 100 days since leaving office, the former jackass in chief has already arranged a big Wall Street payday. Motherfucker. Okay? He doesn't have to drive a car. What I saw it on CNN today. Oh, I'm not driving cars. I don't.
I haven't driven a car, and now I experience traffic like normal people. You know what traffic you should experience? You should experience the traffic in a jail cell to use the same bathroom, oh dumbass. The same toilet. That's the only traffic you should be experiencing nowadays, okay? Unbelievable. Unfucking believable. Have your exclusive. Clinton sex accusers slam hypocritical media over Bill O'Reilly coverage. I think that whole thing was a scam because, you know, Trump's busting pedos left and right. And I heard from FBI informants that Bill O'Reilly liked to go to Panama and get his freaking dick sucked by, like, little kids. So, you know what? It's a sham. How much money did O'Reilly make leaving Fox News? Okay, everybody else won't tell you this. Well, I'm not everybody else. And I got way bigger balls than Kim Jong-un, don't I? I mean, you don't know what his look like, but he's a fucking gook. I mean, come on. I'm El Gran Montalvo. I got bigger balls than most. Okay? All right? I got bigger balls than Peter North, the porn star. How about that? That's right. But I'm exaggerating a little bit, folks. Look, victims of Bill Clinton's alleged sexual assault blasted the news media for attacking Bill O'Reilly while dismissing their own accusations. You think that's fair? I mean, they don't say anything about Bill Clinton, you know, biting chicks' lips and raping women and the this one and the that one. And then you know what Hillary did? She freaking intimidated all the women that Bill was with. And the media says nothing. She's their darling. She's their Gaia. She can do no wrong. Ah. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of it. You know, and this is the cons. This is the cons where I have with Trump. I talked about the pros. And now here's some cons. Has Trump backstabbed the deplorables by not saying that he's going to lock up Hillary again? I mean, I heard that the FBI is going to open a new investigation, but really, fuck the FBI, because they're the ones that let her get away in the first place. Why don't they lock up Comey? And then they got that clapper guy talking about, oh, Russia. This is the same asshole that said that the NSA wasn't spying on you.
Well, wait a second. Right now, they are stepping on her. Right now.
They are stepping on her.
Yeah.
So Trump's looking to bust her again.
She's involved with some judicial, looking to the judicial watch. They mentioned that she's a subject of investigation. I read through it. Something about her emails, but also just some things. But she's being investigated again.
Yeah, they keep talking about Russia. I'd rather see Hillary's fucking emails. All of them. Especially the ones where she's like sharing a dildo with Huma.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the nitty gritty interesting stuff right there. That's right. The worm that works for the Muslim Brotherhood. Look, folks, judge rules against Trump over blocking funds to sanctuary city. Do you believe that shit? Some cock stain in San Francisco is blocking Trump, sandbagging Trump. It seems that that's the only thing these obstructionists can do. Sanctuaries have caused immeasurable harm to the American people. Don't you think so? I mean, sanctuary cities where any criminal, illegal alien can go, not pay taxes, hell, kill Americans, and still live and go get a latte and wake up in the morning and kill again and not pay any taxes and get free health care and free this, everything free in America.
Well,
as long as you're in a sanctuary city.
Yeah, I think that there should be not just sanctuary cities for immigrants, but they should have, like you said, a sanctuary city for people who don't want to have auto insurance.
How about they open up all the old, like, you know, detention camps for the Japanese during World War II and stuff all these fucking fuckers in there? Huh?
Which fuckers?
You know, the Somalians, the Mexicans, anybody that's here illegally. Get them out of here.
Well, illegally, yeah. I don't know what they're going to do. I mean, how could they justify so many immigrants and America just banking, just allowed to be banked out and support
all these
people that
are
going to bring down our education system, number one, our healthcare
system. And I know that for a fact because in California, I went to go pick up my kid once from school, and I heard these little Guatemalan ladies, oh, no entiendo por qué no Julio Rito. That's because Diabito doesn't hear any English. Oh, estupido. En la casa.
Yeah.
And that being said, folks, you know, I'm about to bust the fucking main vein here. You know, I'm so pissed. But I'm happy with Trump that he's stepping on the palace idiots. And we'll see what happens with North Korea. But you know what? Why don't you just go and do yourself a favor and watch Dr. Strangelove so you can stop worrying about things. Because, you know, they said EMP and then this and that and April 26th. Oh, you know, what's going to happen to Trump? Nothing's happened so far. Trump's got it under control.
Hey, I got a movie of the week. If you guys never
movie
saw
of the
it.
Week. Whoa, new segment.
Yeah, new segment.
This is your final thought slash yeah. movie of the week. Yeah. Hurry up.
Go see The Hunt for the Wilder People.
Oh, my God. Ricky Baker.
Ricky Baker. It's about a deviant kid adopted by a foster family.
He had a big Illuminati triangle on his shirt.
Amazing movie.
Amazing movie.
Five
and
star.
That being said, folks, you've been listening to the one and only Bruce Montalvo. I am the Mexican Rush Limbaugh. And she is. She is the Jaja.
Jaja.
You know who she is. You fucking know.
With the tatas.
With the tatas. They're about to be in my hands, yeah? See you guys next week. Same Montalvo dial, same Montalvo station. See you later!
Shalom!